Because we're the same, and Victor would like to ask a question in Spanish that she can translate it for me.
Thank you very much for a very interesting talk. I think there's a lot of challenging points here, and it's going to inspire a lot of research in the future. Tenemos entonces 15 minutos para preguntas, podemos hacer muchas preguntas y discutir. Les pasamos el micrófono si la quieren hacer en inglés, maravilloso, si no, yo puedo ayudar a traducir.
Within the inverted regions. The inverted regions are very big. There are something like between 7 million and 12 million bases. So pretty much any function you can come up with, there's some genes in there that do that. We did a gene ontology analysis, a GO analysis, to see if they were enriched for particular kinds of genes. No, it's such a big piece of the genome. It's almost 40% of the genome within those regions that there's no particular association with anything. That's a very good question.
Hello. I also work a lot with not recombination, but reproductive isolation in Ethiopia, and I have read that association occurs mainly in the X chromosome. And I have not really been working mainly in an autosomal chromosome. So how can you explain how this kind of behavior, how can this final growth scale can occur in Ethiopia?
Let's go back to that picture. This shows you where the inversions are in these species. There's actually two inversions on the X chromosome, and there's one inversion difference on the second chromosome, which is an autosome. So in fact, in this species, we do see a fairly large effect of the X chromosome. However, when you look at the relative size of inverted regions on the X and on the second chromosome inversions, and if you correct for that to look and see, is there more of an effect on the X given the difference in size of the inversions? In this system, it comes out about the same. Basically, this inversion is about the same size as this inversion, even though one's on the X and one's on the autosome. Their effects, almost the same. So we don't really see a large X effect, particularly in this system, except for the fact there are two inversions rather than one on the X chromosome. It doesn't seem like there's anything particular about the X outside of the fact that it has multiple inversions, at least in our system. However, I know in other systems that is the case. I know in the flycatcher birds, for example, there's a big effect of the X chromosome, independent of anything else. But we don't see that in Drosophila subscura or similis. Good question.
Yes, another question is, do you see the difference between species, between this, the whole difference is between the emergent regions now. So have you seen this any difference between within the inversion, levels of variability within the inversion are the same, or is variability is lower close to the break point and is getting higher in the middle, or is just homogeneous within the inversion?
That's an outstanding question. So within species, if you look here at, let's say for example, well, I should point out in these inversions that every individual Drosophilus is the same here, every individual Drosophilus is the same here, but all of the Drosophilus are different longitudes of pseudoscura. Right? So it's a fixed difference, it's not polymorphic. If you look at it, Drosophila Drosophilus has the derived, the new inversion, and levels of variation in the inversion, in the inverted region in Drosophilus, both here and here, are much lower than levels of variation in pseudoscura, which suggests that maybe the inversion spread by natural selection within Drosophila Drosophilus. Within pseudoscura, you don't particularly see any reduction there. It's all just high variation all the way across. Now, Drosophilus does have both types on this chromosome. And there, yes, I mean, the diversity is very high, but it's because we're averaging this type with that type. So in that place, it's very high. But that's a very good question. In the derived arrangements, you see much lower variation, consistent with the spread of those inversions by selection within Drosophila Drosophilus.
Thank you.
Good question.
My question is, how widespread do you think this mechanism is in the nature?
Very good question. So it's not ubiquitous. I would never argue that all speciation happens by inversions, because we know of many species that don't have inversions. We know of many species where that's not the case. So no, it's not the single explanation by any stretch of the imagination. However, I think when they're rare, they make the process happen more easily. And that's why you tend to see between species more often than expected that there are these inversions. So it basically gives speciation a push. Basically, it's a little bit more likely to work, but it's not just the full explanation. It's not necessary, but it helps.
Let me follow on that last point. Even the speciation, is this okay? Even the speciation of personalist and pseudo-obscura must involve something besides inversions.
Absolutely.
Because there's complete recombination between the X chromosome and chromosome number 2, and very high recombination between the two inversions that are on the X chromosome. Nevertheless, presumably, there is an association between those inversions that we call pseudo-obscura versus the inversions that we call presumptuous.
Absolutely.
So what maintains the association among over the entire genome, especially among those inversions?
That's an outstanding question. Basically, what makes it so this inversion is always associated with this inversion in software or syphilis, for example? Part of the answer there, I don't know the full answer, the real answer we don't know. I'll show you the speculative answer. In cases, for example, with this, if you have this piece from persimilis and this piece from pseudobscura, or this piece from either one of those heterozygotes, you almost always have a sterile lot. So in that case, you are having epistasis between the X chromosome and the second chromosome that are facilitating these things. And obviously that is gene independent there. So that seems to be at least part of the explanation. I'm sure there's more to it than that, but it's a good question. These are great questions.
Somebody else? Right. Thank you very much again for your very interesting talk.